Good day, everyone. This is your European Open Briefing for Tuesday, May 2nd. My name is Michael Florentiades. I am the chief economist here at XM.com. These are the key points you should know about for today's trading. Dollar-yen has gained on positive risk sentiment, as we have seen the Nasdaq in the United States overnight recording a fresh all-time high. Treasury yields also gain on prospect that the US government is going to issue longer-term bonds. And the Reserve Bank of Australia kept interest rates unchanged. The Aussie was mixed, as Chinese data also missed estimates. And for the remainder of the day, there is little in the way of key data. We have UK manufacturing PMIs, Eurozone unemployment, and US vehicle sales later on. And just a reminder of what happened yesterday. We had weaker than expected both personal income as well as consumption. So for March, this was disappointing. Of course, most of the world was on holiday yesterday, except for the United States amongst the major markets. We also had a drop in the core PCE price index, an index that the Fed watches very closely. The year-on-year rate fell to 1.6% from 1.8% the previous month. And we also had a lower than expected ISM manufacturing PMI, quite a drop from 57.2 to 54.8, as you can see over there. So there were some weaker than, nothing disastrous, but weaker than expected data. But this didn't have a negative effect on the dollar. You can see the dollar index, it's holding on to around the 99 level. The euro is holding on to 109, as Emmanuel Macron still has strong chances to win Sunday's second round election in France and become president. In geopolitics, we had tension in the Korean